So guys, what's up? This is Case Money Matters. I once made a video about courses that you should do that are very marketable and courses that could pay you so well. But one thing I've also said in this particular channel is that it doesn't matter whatever you do right now in terms of degree, diploma, certificate. What matters is the fact that you are willing to learn and learn and relearn. You are willing to take up different skills that can make you valuable, that can make people see you as someone they want in their team. So it's no longer about certificates. It's no longer about the degrees that you have. It's no longer about those papers. It's about skills. And I did do a video about my own journey in this particular channel, and I shared how many times I've had to learn new skills despite having some of the best courses you can imagine out there. Not just having those courses, but I also performed quite well in those courses. So despite all that and going to some of really good schools, both in Kenya and in Europe, I still had to do a lot of relearning, a lot of different skills, varied skills, so that I could be able to actually cope up with the moving environment, with the changing world, and be seen as very valuable. So if you do courses that, you know, are just generic, probably you could do things like law, you could do things like political science, international relations, all these arts courses, you have to be willing to always do more. So for example, someone like me, I had a background in law, I had a background in political science. I now have a background in finance and investments, but I've still had to do other skills on the side to make me very valuable, such that even if I bring the theoretical knowledge, I still bring in certain skills. And because things are moving towards the technical side, you have to be sure that you are moving with the world. So if you remain fixated at a particular place, you are likely to be left behind. So I have done that here. And today I'm going to compile a list of courses that are not degrees, but diploma courses that could be actually better than degrees. So a lot of people are going to school right now, and some going to universities, some going to colleges, some going to polytechnics, some going to, you know, different institutions basically. But I want to tell you, if you are watching this and you're at home and you did not perform so well, or you didn't manage to get to the university level, or you didn't manage to reach the entry cutoff, or you are not called for a good course that you like, you can start doing something that you like, something that's marketable from a diploma stage, and that's okay. Nobody is saying you must have a degree, and trust me, people with degrees are earning way less right now sometimes if they do not have the necessary skills that the market require. But sometimes diploma courses can actually give you those skills, and then you can scale it up as much as you want. So guys, as usual here at Case Money Matters, we talk about the money mindset, how to make that money, how to manage that money, how to invest that money, and how to assure yourself of a lifetime of income, basically financial freedom. So these are diploma courses, diploma level. The fee will be probably lower, but they could actually be much better than some degree courses. I'm not saying all. So of course, it depends. What are you comparing? You can't compare oranges and apples. So for example, we won't compare nursing and being a doctor, right? Because being a doctor will always be an upper level compared to nursing. But nursing could be a really good course that could give you an edge in the market and an opportunity to scale compared to other courses that you could do in the university. So let's go through this list. Let's see what you think. Please tell me, what course are you doing? What course have you been called for? If you are watching, what are you going to do? Ask me if you think it's marketable. We can have a discussion about it and then see what next. What I advise people after going through my journey, don't do a course for anybody. Do a course that makes you happy, and also not just make you happy, by the way. Do a course that's going to help your future. Because again, if you do something because it makes you happy, but it's not marketable, you are likely to waste a lot of time, a lot of energy, and then later you still have to reskill again. So it's much easier to start reskilling as early as possible. Focus on something that you think has a clear trend, has a clear trajectory, has a clear opportunity for growth, and it's not going to be replaced by all this IT and AI and cloud computing and stuff like that. So make sure you are taking something that you can see a very clear trend, clear need for it in the society, and you can also use it to provide value on your own even without being employed. Again, we also have to come off the mindset of employment and get into the mindset of, can I open my own stuff? Can I start my own business? Can I start my own farm? Can I start my own thing and build my own project using this particular knowledge? Does it give me some real skills? That's the question. Does this course give me some real skills? If you ask yourself that and then you find that it also makes you happy, you're in a good place. Which are some of these diploma courses that could be better than degree courses in Kenya in 2021? Number one, I would say, is diploma in clinical medicine and surgery. And for me, this is one of the best courses because you can never tarmac out there. The health industry always needs people. In the UK recently, you saw the president of Kenya came to the UK and they spoke about having nurses come over here. Our clinical medicine and surgery department also have those opportunities. You can go to not only the UK, they're wanted in Canada, in the US, in Ireland, in so many areas, such people are wanted. That knowledge is always in demand. So if you do clinical medicine and surgery, it's a diploma course, but very good one. It also offers you an opportunity for growth. It's very clear trajectory on where you're going to. What is your next step? Where do you want to? You are in the health industry, so what is your next step? What do you want to do next? If, for example, you wanted to get into medicine, but you couldn't cut it and you can't get to that level, there's no need wasting your time going to do social arts that you don't like. Get into the diploma stage, start there, and then you can scale it higher. That's number one. Number two is diploma in pharmacy. Diploma in pharmacy is a really good one. Again, you can also start your own pharmacy. You can start your own project. You can do your own things besides just getting employed. But generally, all over the world, in Europe, in the US, in Canada, diploma in pharmacy, people never tarmac with that kind of diploma because there are so many people out there who require pharmacists. And the health industry is so big and there are so many ways within the pharmacy where you can actually rebrand yourself, you can actually get into and scale and grow as a pharmacist. So diploma in pharmacy is number two. Number three for me is diploma in education. Again, education is always in demand. If you do a diploma in education and you can go teach in high school, you always sure that at one point you're going to get employed. So if you're someone looking for employment, you're doing a course that you one day want to get employed, you can always do that. And besides just getting employed, if you have a diploma in education, it can help you in so many ways. It can help you in terms of finding opportunities to, you know, to always educate people. And there are so many ways you can educate people, not just in a school. There are so many opportunities, so many platforms that you can actually leverage to educate people. So diploma in education does not only help you in teaching a classroom. Diploma in education actually prepares you for some of the most difficult tasks in life that involve interaction, involves teaching, involves educating consistently and continuously. Whichever field you branch into, because sometimes later you could actually branch into a completely different field. It's not fixed that if you do a diploma in education, you have to be a teacher. You could branch into other things in your life later. And trust me, this is one of the skills you will always transfer to other areas of life so effortlessly, and it will help you scale. So of course, when you're going for diploma in education, you also want to choose some of the courses that will be very marketable for you. For example, if you want to be teaching in school, you want to look at which courses are really in demand, things like sciences, chemistry, physics, mathematics, stuff like that. You will always have opportunities. And then we have diploma in IT. Information technology is still getting better and better. And not just generally, of course, you can do a diploma in IT, but at some point you need to specialize. But a diploma in information technology will always be much better than, for example, BCom. You focus on really making your skills much better than most people in that particular field, you will always get opportunities. And something like IT, even if you are to leave Kenya, go to Europe, go to the UK, go to US, go to all these other countries, you will always find opportunities. So you don't need to rebrand completely. You don't need to start up fresh, like most people do when they get abroad. You can always find ways of incorporating IT into whatever you want to do. And opportunities for IT are immense out here. In Europe, in the West, basically, the opportunities are immense. So you can decide which field you want to go to. But if you start at the diploma level, it means you already have that foundation. With regards to IT, you can go to whichever direction you want. There are so many levels you can scale this. You can get into data, you can get into cloud computing, you can get into AI, you can get into cybersecurity, engineering, IT management, all these things. So there are so many levels in which you can scale your IT. It can be personal, you can do it as a job, you can also do it as your own business, you can do it as a freelancer. When it comes to IT, the world is your oyster at this particular moment and the kind of shift we are experiencing. Start somewhere, start small, do an IT course, and make sure that you are skilling it as much as possible. Make sure that you're making the best of the opportunity and getting those skills as much as possible. And then I always say that if I'm to ever have a child, I would try in my best that they get into something engineering. engineering is one of the best courses right now. There's a huge shift into building economies. There's a huge shift into building new infrastructure. People are looking into the future. If you look at places like China, places like the US, places like the UK, people are looking into the future. In the next 20 years, what are we going to have in terms of the trends, in terms of the infrastructure, the IT infrastructure, the road systems? Engineering field is amazing. If you look at developing countries like Kenya, like different parts of Africa, Congo, Malawi, Rwanda, we are looking all into the future. What are we going to be doing in the future? How are our roads going to be? How are our transport systems going to be? This is the right place to be. If you look at some countries like Kenya, right now we're even talking about oil. So if you are going to engineering in that kind of field, then you're sure you'll always have opportunities. So diploma in engineering, if you cannot cut it to the university level, don't waste your chances doing something you don't like. Start diploma in engineering, whichever field you choose, and then scale it higher. And you always have an immense opportunity for growth when it comes to engineering. So that is definitely something you want to look into. I'm excited about engineering because I know so many people making lots of money in this particular field. So the future is in engineering. I always say, if you're not doing something in engineering right now, it's very difficult to actually scale things as fast as possible. But engineering will always give you the opportunity to scale things as much, much faster than most people. Again, it's dependent on you. Of course, if you don't like it, you don't want to force yourself because that will be too daunting. But if you love this field, this is a place to be. Because engineering has now scaled into all fields. There's engineering in farming, engineering in medical fields, engineering in infrastructure, engineering in IT, engineering in data. Is across the field. Then we have diploma in architecture, and this is one of the best places you can go to. This is where money lies. So if you want to go into architecture and you don't have the money, you don't have the cutoff points to get to the university, this is one of the things that could actually make your future much more brighter, and it's something that you go into if you love it. So some people always say, oh, you have to go to university to get these things. No, you can start from the diploma level and start designing things that we want, like houses. So this is something that will always be in demand. We'll always require architectures. And I don't think there will ever be enough because not so many people are in this particular field. So that's a diploma course that would definitely make your life much easier. Then we have diploma in finance and accounting. Again, people are realizing they don't have to work for people for the rest of their lives. People are opening, you know, businesses, side hustles. Small businesses always require accountants. Big businesses always require auditors and financial experts. The finance field is always growing. So if all the other fields are growing, the health field, the farming industry, the education industry, if all those sectors are growing, then you're sure that the finance sector will always be growing, the accounting sector will always be growing, and you can always scale it and make money. As long as you make sure you have the most recent certifications, the most recent skills, you're doing your best, you will always have an opportunity when it comes to finance and accounting. So this is an area that will never die because everything else depends on finance, and that's where we are, you know. So being in finance, being in accounting is always a good opportunity. People are always looking for accountants. People are always looking for financial experts. So if you cannot get it at the university level, start at the diploma level. Then we have a diploma in procurement and sales management. Now, everything is about sales. We are always selling. I'm selling, you're selling, someone is selling somewhere. We are always selling something. So a diploma in procurement and sales management, if you're in Kenya, for example, this is a good course for you. There are certain certifications that you will require to make you, you know, have an edge with regards to all the other people in the market. But yes, procurement, sales management, this is a good area to go. If you're a good salesperson and you love the sales world, people are paid upwards of $350,000 as a sales manager somewhere, because this is what drives the companies. Whichever sector you're going to, sales will always be required. So if you're in the health sector, there will be a salesperson. If you're in the IT sector, there will be a salesperson. If you're in the agricultural sector, there will be a salesperson. So sales, procurement and sales will always be a marketable field. Finally, we have a diploma in business management. Again, human resource and business management, like I said, will always require people to manage people. So again, this will require you to specialize because it's very general sometimes. If you specialize in a particular area, whether it is HR, whether it is just management of people, leadership management, then you can always scale that up and make lots of opportunities. So guys, I hope these courses help you determine where you want to go to. If you don't want to go and waste your time in campus, then you can start somewhere and scale it high. If you feel that you can also do them at the degree level, of course, that's always a good opportunity. What I wanted to pass across is that you don't have to cut off your dreams for doing certain things just because you could not get to university. You don't have the money to start it somewhere. You don't have the, you know, the support. You can start at the diploma level or even at the certificate level. So if you want me to talk about the certificate courses that are good again, comment below, give me some likes, let me know, and then we can talk about touch. Otherwise, guys, thank you. And pass this to someone who needs it. Pass this to someone making a decision now on what they want to do in the future. And you can just help someone make a decision. Thank you, guys, and see you next time.